एवरीवन, दिस इज विश्वविद्यालय मेट्रिकुलेशन हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल इन एलमलई। युवर ड्रीम्स आर नर्चर्ड हियर। अवर स्कूल विजन इज टू बी द मोस्ट प्रिपेयर्ड स्कूल टू कल्टिवेट ह्यूमन वैल्यूज इन एवरी चाइल्ड टू ग्रो अप एज ए सेल्फ एस्टीम्ड इंडिविजुअल। अवर स्कूल विजन इज वी एनविसेज टू क्रिएट ए लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट where students, teachers and parents work together to develop academic excellence, personal responsibility and ethical behavior. Our school core value is be honest, be disciplined, be creative, be punctual, be healthy and be spiritual. Hello everyone, this is C. Ramachandran, working as a BG assistant and the head of the Department of English in Vishwavidyalaya Matriculation Higher Secondary School, Yelamalai. Hello my dear students, today we are going to be discuss the topic is The Aged Mother, written by the famous folktale writer in Japan, Matsuo Basho. So before we are going to start the lesson, we must know about the writer's personal details, okay? So let's start. So students, first we must know about the author's personal details, okay? Matsuo Basho, he was born in 1644 in Japan. He is one of the most famous poets in Japan, okay? He also called that supreme Japanese haiku poet. Haiku, what's mean that haiku? Haiku is nothing but it's one of the short form of the poet, okay? Which is consist in 17 lines pattern, like 5 plus 7 plus 5. So which is consist of 17 lines poem, which is called a haiku poem, okay? So in Japan, many of his poems are seen on monuments and traditional sites. He introduced to poetry at a young age and he became a very popular poet in Japan. He made a living as a teacher, but later he traveled throughout the country to gain inspiration for his writing. Okay, let's see. So students, let's see the lesson. Setting and the characters, okay? Setting, Shinano at the bottom of this mountain, okay? It's one of the village in Japan. Shinano is one of the village, okay? Then character, the aged mother, first character. She is the main character of the story, who has the wisdom that brings to save and benefited their life, okay? Then the young farmer, the son of the aged mother, the cruel king, an unkind ruler who ordered to kill all aged people in the country. Okay, let's see the outline of the story. Okay, so students, let's see the outline of the story, The Aged Mother. Okay, the poor farmer and his aged mother lived at the bottom of the mountain. The ruler of the country passed on order to kill all the aged women. So the young farmer took his mother to the mountain. He was moved by her love and care for him. He carried her down to the mountain and hid her in a hut. One day the ruler passed on order to present him with a rope of ashes. Rope of ashes means the people should create rope with ashes, okay? But it is impossible to create, okay? The farmer made a rope of ashes and presented it to the king, which was he expected, okay? At last the ruler understood the wisdom of the old mother and he realized that his mistake, okay? So students, this is the outline of the story. Let's see the text, okay? The Japanese folktale. Once upon a time, there was a poor young farmer and his widowed mother were lived in China at near the mountain. They had some cultivated land which was supplied the food for their whole life. Okay. They were humble. Their life was full of peaceful and happy. In China, there is a poor farmer and his widowed mother lived in the near the mountain. Their life is full of peaceful. Okay. Then the man, the king of Sinin country. He was a king and he was a leader and he was a soldier. But he was a coward. He has feared to take war against with the other country. The king had a good healthy body and strength. One day the king announced to the people the cruel proclamations. Okay. The king announced that all the aged people must be put to death. All the aged people must be put into the death. He thought that they are useless. The king thought that the old people are useless people to the country. So he thought they are useless for the developing of this country. So the king announced to the people, kill all the aged women, all the aged women and the unhealthy people. It is common to kill all the aged people mercilessly. So the king ordered to the people, kill all the aged people and unhealthy people. At the same time, he informed to all, kill them with the mercilessly. So really, he is the cruel king of this Sinin country. Okay, let's see another paragraph. So the poor young farmer loved his aged mother. Okay, king's cruel announcement made him heartbroken and feel sad. Okay, when king's announced the cruel announcement, it was broken the young farmer heart and he upset to kill his mother. Okay, but he had to plan to leave from the country. No one should come forward to reduce the king's words, so that he also ready to kill his mother with kindest and mercilessly mode of death. Okay, so we cannot reduce the king's order. So he is the common people from the country. So the young farmer also ready to kill his mother with mercilessly way. Okay, then. So the young farmer planned to leave the country because he cannot kill his mother with mercilessly. That's why he want to leave the country to save his mother. Okay. In the evening of sundown, he finished his work and prepared the food for the dinner. After he cooked, he had dried it and tied it in a cloth. Okay, so the young farmer, after cooked, he tied it a food and tied in a cloth. Then he ready to leave with food and cool water. Okay, so the farmer want to leave the country with food and cool water. Okay, without food we cannot be alive. That's why the farmer bring the food and water. Okay, then he ready to leave the country. So the painful journey towards the Obatsuyama. Obatsuyama is the big mountain in Japan. So the young farmer lifted his old helpless mother to his back. Okay, the farmer lifted his mother in his back and he started his painful journey towards the Obatsuyama mountain. On the journey, the road was long and steep. The road has many paths, many different ways, because it was made by the hunters and the woodcutters. He was confused by the different way of road, but he moved towards the mountain Obatsuyama. Obatsuyama, it was the place of abandoning of aged people. Okay. Then on the way to the Obatsuyama mountain, the young farmer's old mother was noted that different road towards the mountain. So the old woman thought that on the way back to her house, her son did not know the mountain's different way, and she thought his return must be one of the danger. Okay, so the old woman thought her son did not know the ways of return to his house. So she thought his return should be a danger. Okay, so the old woman planned to pluck the leaves from their twigs from as they passed. Okay, and also she chopped the leaves, still the mountain. She thought it will guide them to reach the house. So the old woman planned to pluck the leaves from the twigs from as they passed, and also she chopped the leaves till the mountain. She thought it will guide him to reach his house, come back. So at last they were reached the mountain. The young farmer and the old mother were reached the mountain. He was so tired and heartbroken and heartsick. Then he prepared the comfortable place for his mother in the mountain, Ubhadshyama. When he leave from mountain, he felt heartbroken and said farewell to his mother. Because it is very different things to send our mother in the dangerous place. And finally, the young farmer said farewell to his mother. Okay, then, so when he was ready to leave the mountain, his mother told him, the mountain road is full of dangerous. The mountain road is full of dangerous. Look carefully and follow the path which was covered by the small leaves. It will guide you to reach our house. Then the young farmer understood his mother's real love and care. And he cried aloud himself, oh my dear honorable mother, oh my dear honorable mother, your kindness breaks my heart. Your kindness breaks my heart. I will not leave you. I will not leave without you. I will not leave without you. He said, we will follow the path of twigs and we will die together and we will go together to our house. Then both are ready to leave the mountain, and the young farmer lifted his mother in his back. Okay. Then once again he lifted his lovable old mother and his back, and he ready to move towards the mountain in the moonlight of night. After he reached his house, the young farmer hid his mother inside the kitchen. In the kitchen, he gives everything to his mother, like food and water for everything he gives to his mother. Sometimes he has some fear whether his mother should be found out or not. He has a fear to find out his mother or not. And a few days later, the king announced that another cruel proclamation, that is, the people should present the rope of asses. The rope of asses. Okay. So the whole country trembled with fear because the king's order must be obeyed. But in the shiny country, no one would make it in the rope of asses. So the young farmer went to his mother and told the news of king's second cruel announcement. Then his mother gives best idea to make it the rope of asses. Dear son, make rope of twisted straw and put it upon a row of flat stones, and you may burn it on a windless night. After burning, the blast died down. Then you may get the rope of asses and you may bring it to your governor. Then the young farmer did the same thing, and he got the rope of asses and he ready to present to his governor. Okay. Finally, the ruler called the people together and hand over the rope of asses, so that the young farmer, showing his perfect lay of rope of asses, after seeing the rope of asses, the ruler appreciated the wisdom of young farmer's creativity. But the ruler asked to young farmer, where you had obtained this wisdom. But the young farmer told the whole story of his life. Then the governor listened, and then he meditated in a silence. He told the story. His mother only told the idea how to create the Dropa vases, so that the governor listened and then meditated in a silence. Finally, he lifted his head and said, "Shining country needs more than strength of youth. Shining countries need more than strength of youth." He said sadly, "The wisdom comes from the elderly persons." He said, and he understood, the wisdom comes from the elderly persons. At last, the governor realized his mistakes about the cruel proclamations of the cruel rules and law. At last, he abolished the cruel laws from the country. Then the young farmer saved his mother, and he lived happily in the village. Okay, you guys, from this story, in the world there is unselfish people should be there in the world. She is only the mother. Okay, our mother love is unmeasurable. We cannot measure the our mother's love. Okay, so old is gold. Give respect to our elders, and the knowledge comes from learning, and the wisdom comes from the living. So this is the moral of the story. So you guys, I hope all are understood well. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you.